Hello and welcome to week two of Small Bites and Insights with Ventureprise. My name is Laura Smales. I am the Assistant Director at Ventureprise. We are the Innovation and Entrepreneurship Center on UNC Charlotte's campus. We work with professors, students, faculty, and working on elevating the research to another level. We try to look at commercialization possibilities. We look at starting businesses, starting programs, but we really are trying to reach across campus in different colleges and departments and look at the different types of research that we're doing. We're doing some really great things here on campus, and we're wanting to reach out. That's the purpose of this Zoom series, Insights. And we want to highlight different departments and colleges across campus. So virtually each week, we are going across campus and finding some amazing people. We have an amazing panel today. We are highlighting the Belk College of Business, Belk Scholars, and then we also have the Levine Scholars Program on today. So I'm going to take a moment and let my esteemed panel introduce themselves. So Dr. Randle, if you would like to start first and talk about your program.
Good morning. Thank you so much for having me. We're excited to be here and talk a bit about our Business Honors Program as well as our Belk Scholars Program. First, though, our college, the Belk College of Business, is celebrating our 50th anniversary. So we have a lot going on this year in celebration of that 50th anniversary. We are extremely proud of our Belk Scholars. And so Belk Scholars Program, a collection of our high achieving students who have interest in quantitative type career fields. So currently we have 27 students that are part of Belk Scholars Program, and they are majoring in a variety of majors in business. And then in their fifth year, they will receive or earn graduate degrees in either math, finance, economics, or data science and business analytics. So they do some pretty awesome things. Also, they are part of our Business Honors Program, which currently has about 125 students, and they participate in leadership, professional development, social events, community service. One of the big takeaways or benefits of our Business Honors Program, of which our Belk Scholars are members, is the professional development. So we have folks out of our business community that come join us about twice a month to talk about issues in their professions, to lead and guide them, to develop them, to network with them, so that they can be successful in their careers. So we're excited to be here, and even more excited to share the stage with Adonis and Samra, who are members of our Business Honors Program.
And Dr. Zablotsky.
Good morning. It's wonderful to be with you all. I am the director of the Levine Scholars Program. I'm also a faculty member in the sociology department. The Levine Scholars Program currently has 84 scholars. We are in our 11th year of the program. So we also have the same approximate number of alums that have gone through the various opportunities and programs across UNC Charlotte. We are open to all majors. But we are a program that is 4 years comprehensively. So our students are Levine Scholars from being accepted as incoming freshmen through their 8 semesters until they graduate and go on to do some amazing things. So we're happy to talk about some of the research opportunities that we have, the way we collaborate across campus, and some of the ways that our alums have gone on moving forward and building on the foundation that they created when they were Levine Scholars.
Great, thank you. And Samra.
Hi, I'm Samra Kanwal, and I am currently a sophomore within the Levine Scholars Program. I'm currently in the Belk College of Business, as well as the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences, majoring in business and history. This summer, I was fortunate enough to become a part of Ventureprise with my project called Volunto, in which we try to connect college students in innovative ways to local nonprofits and help them grow and accelerate. Doing Ventureprise has been such an amazing boon, not only in elevating my own business idea, but also connecting me to like-minded entrepreneurs, as well as companies within Charlotte and beyond that will really allow me to not only make important connections for my career, but also just learn more about what else is there for me to do and really narrow in and hone in on my interests. It's been absolutely amazing. as well as in the Levine Scholars Program, the ample amount of opportunities we get to explore our interests and to finally decide what we want to do with our lives, that has been such an amazing kind of avenue for us to do. This past summer, I was able to intern with a local nonprofit, and every summer we get to do have these amazing experiences that are just monumental in defining our lives and our careers.
Perfect. Thank you. And Adonis.
Good morning. Thanks for having me. My name is Adonis Abdullah. I am now a senior in the Belk College of Business, double majoring in business analytics and economics. And I'm also entering my first semester for the data science and business analytics graduate program, which is in the School of Data Science. And I got introduced to Ventureprise last fall 2019, with my idea for Hot Route Analytics, which is a sports analytics firm that works with small universities and wants to build communities there around the spirit of competition. And we do that through our apps, our technology, and our insights. And it's a pleasure to be here.
Perfect. And I'm gonna go ahead and insert that you won that competition that you entered in fall of 2019. And then you also won a place in our summer accelerator this past summer. So we'll get more into all of that as well, but want to definitely like introduce that portion of you. I want to bring it back around to the actual programs and really talk with Dr. Zablotsky and Dr. Randle about what's the basis of your programs? What are you looking to do with some students? Dr. Zablotsky, if you'd like to start off first by just giving an overview of the mission maybe and sort of expanding on some of the projects that you've seen come through.
Sure. The Levine Scholars Program is the premier scholarship program at UNC Charlotte, and so it's competitive in a whole lot of ways. Our pillars, like many other premier scholarship programs, are academic excellence, ethical leadership, and civic engagement. We really are interested in students whose value system emanates from a sense of giving back, of paying forward, of going in ways that will leave their community, however they define their communities, to be in a better space than they were previously. So we do provide summer support. So our students do nonprofit internships in the Charlotte community the summers before their sophomore year. They also have opportunities and requirements to study abroad. And we've had a number of students in colleges across the university that have done volunteer work and civic engagement kinds of work, and also entrepreneurial work, even when they were studying in other countries, which is very exciting for us. Like many other programs, we are committed to providing a foundation and an opportunity for as much research, creativity, entrepreneurship as possible, no matter where it comes from, because we know there are so many ways that students can collaborate and tie in to their home departments, to organizations like Ventureprise, and take their ideas and get additional support from faculty and professional staff to make their ideas come to fruition. And so they do that in a variety of ways. Internally, we do have some opportunities that are for scholars. We have a research mentoring initiative which connects students in their freshman and sophomore year with on-campus and community organizations, so they can learn the research process, both in social science and natural sciences, and some kind of civic engagement research right from early in their careers. But we also work with scholars and encourage them to work with other faculty to present their papers at conferences. So we're heavily involved with the Undergraduate Research Conference, with the National Conference of Undergraduate Research, with the State Conference of Research, and help students develop research projects and papers that they can present in their disciplines as well as they move through their 4 years. We also have found ways to create research opportunities when we teach study abroad courses. So we've gone to South Africa and to Shanghai and to Jerusalem, and students find ways to conduct undergraduate research that starts in another country and that they can follow up with when they return to UNC Charlotte and do some cross-national examinations and move forward in their disciplines in that way as well. And then finally, we really do try and connect students who are building a four-year platform that allows them to be competitive at whatever graduate school programs they want to aspire to. We've had students who have been Fulbright winners. We have students who have already created their own businesses, and we've only had 6 years of graduates, so people move at a fairly fast pace. We've had people successfully compete to get into Harvard and Stanford and Berkeley and Columbia and Penn. And so if the aspiration is to be creative and involved and committed and entrepreneurial in your undergraduate years so that you can be competing at the highest level for your next academic journey, we're committed to providing that foundation as well. The reason that I think our scholars are so successful is because of the broad base of support they get across the university, both in their academic departments, but also in the opportunities across the Honors College. Many of them are in multiple majors and multiple colleges, which is very exciting. But they also find ways to integrate their practical experiences, their internships, their research opportunities, and their international exposure to put together very exciting undergraduate opportunities and move forward in very, very exciting ways.
That's great, perfect. And then Dr. Randle?
So Levine is absolutely awesome.
I was like, and okay.
but we are equally excited about Belk Scholars and Business Honors. So it's really difficult for me to talk about one in isolation. So I talk about them collectively.
Absolutely, perfect.
So our focus is to professionally develop our students. So we think that we do a great job in the College of Business for students who are not in those programs, but we add something additional for students who are in Belk Scholars or Business Honors. And that is bringing in our business community. So with Business Honors, we admit students in their freshman year or their sophomore or their junior year. So there are different options for the way we admit. With our Belk Scholars, we admit in their freshman year and support them throughout their graduate education. And so some of the unique things or unique features about our programs are that our students are required to do have leadership positions. Our students are required to serve their communities. As a matter of fact, they all sign an integrity contract as they enter the program. And it basically says that we will participate in academic, that we will, uphold respect and honor and integrity and service to others above ourselves. So we try to put all of those things together for our students in the programs. Part of the program is that the students will have an experiential learning component. So study abroad or internships. And many of our students choose both. So they do an internship abroad or do an internship or a study abroad experience. And in those opportunities, they are building this foundation for being a very attractive candidate whenever they are out on the job market. Additionally, our business community regularly contacts us for access to our students. So when we have meetings, for example, I mentioned earlier that we'll have a professional meeting today. We have representatives from Bank of America, from Ally, from Truist. And then at the end of their studies, they are placed with companies like Bank of America, Ally, Truist, Wells Fargo, Deloitte, Carroll Financial, the London Stock Exchange. So there are lots of opportunities for our students to be professionally developed so that they can be those business leaders in the business community. Additionally, part of the capstone experience for honors is that they either take our strategic management course or they write a thesis. And so the big part of the research comes in that thesis process. And so we've had students, do research on NFL drafts and some of the characteristics of athletes to actually go to the NFL draft. We've had students who've been published before they even graduated from their undergraduate studies in cross-disciplinary research. By working with some of the faculty members, both in our college and outside of our college. We've had students who are working even right now on projects related to COVID-19. So in the honors courses, they are getting an added level of critical thinking in the mode of instruction. So not traditional lecture, but more critical thinking or inquiry in those courses, which crafts these ideas that they are interested in working with faculty members. And so our faculty members are well aware of our business honor students and our scholars and are very much interested in working with them as well. And so they've had many of these opportunities to research. So many of our students choose the strategic management capstone as opposed to the thesis. Mm-hmm. However, when we do have students that are interested in the research route, then we are very much supportive of that. So even the undergraduate research symposium that we have here on campus, mm-hmm. We have students that travel to do research and presentations, and so we support them in that. So I think, you know, one of the big things about, you know, from a College of Business perspective, and our honors and scholars, is that while we are preparing them in terms of professional development to be business leaders, we are also supporting them in their interest to doing research. And so the Belk Scholars Program, we have our second group of scholars in graduate programs now. So we are relatively young in the scholars program, but they have done, you know, a wide variety of things in terms of internships and research and the like in our programs.
Great. You both brought up a lot of great points that I'm sort of going to have Adonis and Samra, you know, sort of showcase. So we've heard leadership, we've heard multidisciplinary, we've heard experiences. And I think these two students, all of us have worked with them. I think they represent a lot of this. And so Adonis, I'm going to go to you first, but going through the programs at the Belk College of Business, and then also doing Ventureprise, where we do customer discovery, and that's what we're teaching you as the basis of our programming, where you're going out and you're talking to different industry leaders, different potential customers, but you had this research, you had this innovation, and you're sort of taking it to a different level. So how did doing a combination of all of these sort of work for you, and how did that elevate what you were doing, and not only your research, but also you're starting a business, but you sort of have a representation of all of these, I think.
Yeah, and I would say, you know, the experiences that I've gotten from being a Belk Scholar and being a part of Ventureprise have been really, really pivotal for me. You know, one experience I've had being here and being an honor scholar is that I've done this 4-year research project. And that's been really cool, as it's taught me just how to approach a question and the systematic process of going through and finding the answer. And it's been a really cool process in that regard. And it's just sparked that intellectual curiosity. And I feel like that's a needed thing for anyone. And then, you know, on the Belk, as a Belk scholar, furthermore, it's just like helped me get so much exposure, and it's given me so many great experiences as well. You know, ultimately both of these have helped me develop as a person and a professional, which, you know, it's one of those things that's all you really hope for. With the Belk Scholar, being a Belk Scholar, being in BHP, you know, I've had the opportunity to be in front of multiple C-suite executives. I've been able to visit the corporate HQ of top companies. I'm now taking graduate courses as an undergraduate student, and it's ultimately really just helped me become comfortable and confident being myself in a professional setting.
And I'll say that's where I have personally seen you grow in the last year, is how you present yourself, your company, how you present what you're doing. I've seen a big difference. And I think it's because I know we force you to do that. We have you get out and do those interviews. And I'm sure some of the resources at Belk does that as well. But looking to see, you know, how did those sort of complement each other as well? You started to talk about that, but if you could go in a little bit more detail.
Yeah, and I would say Ventureprise has really helped me build on those, on the experiences that I've had and the things I've gained from, you know, the scholarship programs. I would say when it comes to, you know, just research and projects, it's helped me think of things in a different way. It's helped give me that second perspective of before it's the what and the how when it comes to research, it seems like, but now it's about the why and the who and the impact that you're making with it. And that's one of the great things with Ventureprise. And, you know, so now I've found that my research is more purposeful and my interactions with professionals are just more insightful. And ultimately, you know, for me, this has helped me advance Hot Rod Analytics. You know, through the customer discovery or through the different pitch challenges we've had, I've just become I've gained the ability to just, you know, call up 30 different professionals in the area and ask them what they think about their industry, just learn and just understanding how things work. And I think that's been a really cool thing. And as you said, you know, Ventureprise really helped me take that to the next level.
I was going to go ahead and tell you were done when you said you went from the what and the how to the why. I was like, okay, now we're done. Mic drop. But Samra, if you could follow up with that and sort of talk about your journey, because your journey has just started. We just, you came in last year as a freshman. So sort of talk about some of your research, some of your experience, you know, with your projects, what you're looking to do through Levine, and how Ventureprise has sort of helped complement some of that you're doing.
Absolutely. I took the Levine scholarship initially just because of the immense amount of dedication the program had to giving back and turning us into the service leaders of tomorrow. I really saw that in the program, and that was something what I wanted to do. Quite interestingly, I came in as a social work major because I thought that was the best way I could impact my community. And just discovering myself through the programs that Levine has been quite impactful. In addition, I would say with the Levine Scholars Program and Ventureprise, I've been working with them in combination of each other. So when I was doing my 30 customer interviews, the first people I reached out to were the Levine alumni who were working within these fields and who had these experiences, and they were just so amazing and willing to just get on the phone with me and answer questions about their respective industries. And through them, I was able to meet so many other people. Actually, on volunteer right now, I have a Levine scholar who's working with me, a former Levine scholar who's working with me on this project. So just bridging both of these programs in terms of the connections that it gives me has been absolutely amazing. And another like tie-in that I have is currently, because I'm a business major, I am in the business honors program. And with Volunto, we actually partnered with the business honors program to do our first demo and trial. So just these programs on campus and even outside of campus in terms of their alumni are just so interconnected, and the networks that all three of them give you overlap a lot. And just with those networks, you're able to do so much and elevate your projects, and what your social impact is so much. So that has been an absolutely amazing kind of facet that I've discovered, in addition to the amazing professional development that BHP offers with the just overall experience that Levine gives you. And then with Ventureprise, learning more about your business and customer discovery and actual business plans and your target market, in addition to all of these amazing things, just the people that you get to connect with by being a part of these programs has been, I think, really, really pivotal and impactful in my journey thus far.
Those are great stories. So thank you both for sharing those. So I'm going to go back to the directors of the programs here and ask a question. So we heard these stories, and looking to see what your missions are at the core of your programs, how do you see the multidisciplinary approach and what Ventureprise could offer, and just sort of how do you think they complement each other? Because in my view and how we view it at Ventureprise, it's not just about starting a business tomorrow. We're not saying, we're sort of trying to change that face of entrepreneurship and that definition and say, making an impact. How can you take your ideas and your research to this other level? And as we see, you know, Adonis started a business, and then we have Samra starting a business, but then she's also looking at starting some programs. So it's different views, and you can use these research and this innovation for different levels. It helps with professional development and leadership. And we believe at Ventureprise that all of our customer discovery techniques and exercises help lead to this. But I'll first throw it to Dr. Randle, but how do you see all of these sort of fitting together? And how would you encourage students who are just on campus looking at this that may not, you know, necessarily be a part of these specific programs as well, but what is the importance of going forward and sort of making that initiative to taking that initiative to ask questions and make an impact?
Absolutely. So, you know, one of the things I think when students first come to campus, they think I'm coming here to get a degree. So they are, you know, launching into these courses and they get this course specific knowledge. They write a paper and, you know, think they put a pen in it and that's it. And so I think that part of, you know, even the honors program or Levine Scholars or Ventureprise, even it allows students to take the theory and the project and put it into something that's impactful. Allows them to put a product in the hand of a consumer. It allows them to literally change the world. And so I think it helps in terms of a mind shift. And this is not just for a class. It really is something that I can be passionate about. And I think if students approach it from that respect, that even the projects and the way they study will change. You know, so I'm not just doing this for a class. I'm doing it because it can advance. I believe in calling and purpose in life. So it can advance my calling and my purpose. It can help me change, you know, change the world. You know, the project that Samra's been working on, the projects that Samra's been working on are things that she's really passionate about that are life-changing for others, for example, in Adonis as well. And so, you know, these help students figure out how to take those things from the classroom and into the consumer, into the world. And I think other In addition, just by, you know, watching this or looking at Ventureprise, it is a resource. And so students need more information about the resource. And then we think about kind of partnering with, you know, different organizations on campus, then it is an opportunity for you guys, for example, to come to the business honors program meetings to share more about it. Our students will know that Adonis and Samra are doing these things and how they've been successful and that the resources is available for them. And then we ask them to do these experiential learning opportunities. And this is a way for them to capture this in those experiential learning opportunities. So I think it's awesome and almost a hidden treasure if you feel on campus.
Perfect. And Dr. Zablotsky. Oh, you're on mute.
There we go. I think those are our shared values. I think that those kinds of the intersection of the program on campus helps create a campus-wide culture that promotes accessibility and opportunity and to be bold. I think one of the things that we try very much to do is to support the self-discovery that hopefully undergraduate education provides. And so part of it is to intersect the coursework and the co-curricular and the extracurricular, which I think this kind of programming promotes. I think the other thing that it does is it gives students the confidence and the opportunity to be a bit bolder. I think sometimes we forget that at the beginning of an undergraduate journey, it takes some courage and it takes a lot of self-confidence to reach out to alums, to make a cold call to a business, to pitch an idea. And so I think that sometimes, unfortunately, students don't take those steps or those leaps of faith because they're not supported in doing that. And so what I think the other value system, the interconnection of the ideas and the goals and the organizations and the ties across campus say to students, you can do this, you should do this, and we believe in you. And we're going to give you that foundation from which to do these things. And that's why I think in both Samra getting started through her first year and Adonis doing a four-year journey, I think what you hear is this expanded self-confidence, this expanded body of experience, this expanded boldness in what to do next. And I think that's very exciting. And I think that's really where the intersection of our opportunities come together.
No, that's, I completely understand. And so I'm going to go ahead and go to the students really quick because we have a couple of questions that Brianna, who's monitoring, has come up with. So this goes to both of you and you can answer. As a student entrepreneur, what's a unique challenge that you faced and how did you overcome that? So thinking about your journey, what sort of, what are some of those challenges that you've overcome? Samra, we'll go to you first.
I think for me at this stage in my journey, the biggest challenge has been attempting to find a balance between being a student and all of the responsibilities and work that entails, as well as giving myself and dedicating 100% of myself to the initiatives that I'm working on, to making sure that my project is headed in the direction I am. Sometimes in attempting to find the balance between both of those things, you kind of lose a sense of self because you're working so hard all the time that you don't really have time to just take a step back and reflect and really take care of yourself. And I think that's something that I've learned, is unless I take care of myself and address any problems that I'm having and just reflect, I really can't be successful in both of these things simultaneously at the same time. So just giving myself some breathing room and giving myself time to reflect and think about is so crucial in attempting to negotiate a balance between being a student and being an entrepreneur, because both of these two things are extremely stressful, and then you combine them together and you have this whole new world of just stress. But also it's a passion that people have, so it shouldn't be tedious. You shouldn't with your projects that you're working on feel like it's another responsibility or another thing that you just have to knock out. It should fill you up with joy and fill you, spark something within you. And once you start to lose that a little bit, I think it's just time to step back a little bit and reflect and just go back into why you wanted to do this in the first place.
Right. And Adonis, did you have anything you wanted to add to that? I know you've had, I think I've heard some of the same things that she was mentioning, but.
Yeah, I 100% co-sign everything she's saying. This balance is hard, and it's really important to take a moment for yourself, as she was saying. As you know, Laura, I just came off of a summer where I was putting in 70, 80, even 100 hours a week, like just working between interning, schooling, trying to be an entrepreneur. It's hectic and it can take a toll on you. And I think the one thing I would add, my biggest difficulty is just making sure to keep my mental health in a good state, especially when it comes to anxiety. In such an instant world, going through this slow process of building a company can be really, anxiety inducing. And so just trying to find ways to stay in a good state, stay calm, and, just keeping on, I guess.
Perfect. And then to sort of wrap things up, I'll start with the students again and sort of point out, so you have two sentences or a sentence to give to incoming students or just students on campus. What advice would you give for them to try something different? Adonis, I'm going to go to you first, since Samra had the first time.
I would say, I believe that we all have, ideas and questions in our head that we never really let the world see. And I think there's no harm in exploring them further, especially when the potential for the benefit can be so great in our communities. And so I just encourage anyone to just go out, give it a try, and see how far you can go with something.
And Samra?
Perfect. This is the time for self-discovery. If you're going to try something new, if you're going to experiment, if you're going to succeed, or if you're going to fail, this is the time to be doing it right now. I mean, we're young and we have yet to go out into the world. So if there's any time to explore your passions, it would be now.
Perfect. I like that. And then Dr. Randle and Dr. Zablotsky, one quick question. So seeing what these students have stated, what would be your message in sort of, trying to get some students to ask those questions or to join these programs? What would be your overarching message?
I think mine is to embrace the university in its fullness, that across a campus, you have different disciplines, you have different levels of expertise, you have people with different interests, you have people with lifelong careers and personal journeys, and they're all there for you and to talk with you and encourage you and answer your questions and stimulate your imagination. And so my advice is always take a look around and fully embrace what a university can offer or to you as an undergraduate.
Perfect. And then Dr. Randle?
We are clearly in a time where the problems are not standardized. They are novel and very unique. And so we need unique solutions to the challenges that we face. And so think about that. And as Dr. Zablotsky mentioned, take advantage of the resources across campus. We need the diversity of thought and dealing with or managing the challenges. And you can find that the resource, the connection, the support in different areas across campus to meet the challenges that we are facing.
That's a great ending summary. I did want to touch base. Dr. Randle, while you are there, talk about, I know they're doing some happy 50 years. So I know that you wanted to talk about a few things that you have going on in the College of Business as well.
Absolutely. So in our 50th anniversary for the Belk College of Business, we have a Dean's Leadership Series, and we will be meeting monthly with panels of leadership professionals in the field. So for this coming week, we have a diversity, equity, and inclusion panel, and then we'll meet each month and have a lunchtime lunch and learn. So check that out. And then also we have entrepreneurial decisions. And on Tuesday, October 13th from 6 to 7 p.m. In partnership with the Belk College of Business and the Arts and Design and the Marketplace Series with the College of Arts and Architecture, we'll have an event as well. So we have a lot going on in the college in celebration of our 50th anniversary.
That's great. And I want to thank everybody on this panel. I appreciate your time. I think it's so important to really talk about multidisciplinary research, how we can all work together, how all of our programs can complement each other. We've had two great students that are great examples of what that represents. So I want to thank all four of you. And for those of you that would like more information, here's my email. And then please follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. We have a website. This show will be posted, and if you have any questions, would like to be introduced to any of our esteemed panel today, let me know. We're here for questions. We're here to embrace that, and we really want to make sure that you have knowledge of all the resources here on UNC Charlotte's campus. So thanks to you all. I appreciate it, and we will see everybody next week.